Namaste children, welcome to our science class. Children, can anybody say what we have learned from our last science class? Yes, we have learned about reproduction in plants as well as the types of reproduction in plants, isn't it? And also we have learned that the parts of a flower. Am I correct, children? Then, what is the four main parts of a flower? Yes, sepal or calyx, petals or corolla, stamen or androecium, pistil or gynoecium are the four parts of a flower. Isn't it? Now, have you recalled? Yes. Did you know one thing, children? The presence or absence of these parts of a flower can be classified into two groups, namely the unisexual flowers and bisexual flowers. Children, are you eagerly waiting to learn about the types of flowers and their role in reproduction? Yes, children. Shall we move on to the types of flowers? If the flower consists all the four whorls, that means calyx, corolla, stamen and pistil, then it is called as complete flower. Complete flowers are also called bisexual flowers. You know what is the meaning of bi? Bi means two. That means both male and female parts are present on the same flower. Then what about unisexual flower? In a flower, if any of these four whorls or parts is missing, then it is called as an incomplete flower. Incomplete flowers are also called unisexual flowers. You know what is meaning of uni? Uni means single. That means it contains either male or a female parts. So, unisexual flowers are further divided into male flower and female flower presence of the parts. The flower with androecium and without gynoecium is called as a male flower. The flower with gynoecium and without androecium is known as female flowers. So, both male flower and female flowers are called unisexual flowers. Children, I hope you have understood clearly about the types of flowers, isn't it? That means unisexual flowers and bisexual flowers. Now, shall we move on to the role of flowers in reproduction? That means how flowers can change into fruits. To understand how a flower develops into fruit, let us see an experiment on pumpkin plant. Children, do you know why we have selected pumpkin flowers? Because the flowers of the pumpkin are unisexual. That means some of the flowers are male while many are female flowers in the plant. And we can easily identify the male and female flower buds of pumpkin even before they bloom. It is quite interesting, no, children? Then how we should find this is a male flower and this is the female flower? Let us see how. Male flowers are born straight of the vine, but female flowers have a small fruit swelling at the base near the stem. Can you see this? The small swelling near that stem. So this is called female flower. Now we easily identify which one is male and which one is female, isn't it? Now shall we see the experiment, children? Once pumpkin flower buds appear, immediately identify 10 female flower buds from that plant. Tie a plastic bag around each bud so that no outside material can enter. Make small holes with a pin to allow air flow. And wait for 2 to 3 days to bloom. And in between, choose 3 to 4 male flowers. And pluck the stamens of these flowers and dust or take out the pollen grains in a sheet of paper and collect it. Now open 5 out of 10 bags containing female flowers and brush or apply the collected pollen grains on the stigma with a soft paint brush or hand. And while doing this, take care not to damage the stigma. And after a few days, we can see that flowers in all bags that were not opened at all would wilt or fallen without forming a fruit. While most of the flowers to which the pollens have been applied form fruits. Children, from this experiment, we can clearly understand how flowers changes into fruits. In this experiment, we transferred the pollen grains from male flower to female flower. Isn't it? So, this is called as an artificial pollination. That means the process by which pollen grains reach stigma is called as pollination. The flower that receives pollen grain is called pollinated flower, while the one that did not receive pollen grain is called unpollinated flower. After pollination and fertilization process is over, the ovules develops and become seeds. The sepals, petals and stamen fall off. The ovary starts to store food and swell up to form the fruit. The fruit protects the seeds and helps in their dispersal. Fruits may be fleshy or dry, and they may have one seed or many seeds. But under favorable condition, the seeds germinate into a seedling. So, the new plants arises from seeds. Children, I hope you have clearly understood how flowers changed into fruit and what is the important role in reproduction. Children, shall we recall once again what we have learned from this class? Yes, there are 2 types of flowers. The first one is unisexual flower and second one is bisexual flower. Calyx, corolla, stamen and pistil are present in the same flower, then it is called complete flower or bisexual flower. If any of these 4 parts is missing, then it is called as an incomplete flower or unisexual flower. After the pollination and fertilization process, the flower changes to fruit and fruits have seeds. With help of these seeds, the new plant arises and it is called sexual reproduction. Children, I hope you have understood clearly about the flowers and their role in reproduction. Isn't it? Now we will end up our class with this, children. Thank you, children.